August. What happened here?
Incoming! Get out of there! Now!
Shit.
Hide! There! Go!
Well, what a surprise, yeah, numbers. By the way, after I finish this, I'll show you the way to get a legendary in this place. It's guaranteed legendary. And we just have to activate three little pillar things. And then it will actually open the door. Well, okay game, you want me to defend the entrance, but nothing is coming. Okay, I'll just go myself. She actually made it through, I'm impressed. And they had a small little camp over here to research this stuff. I mean, yeah, there's a big obelisk floating above the valleyway, and that power source is the only thing that's keeping it up. Why does my game look so bad? I don't know. At this point, I don't care. I mean, I increased my graphics settings and it looks worse, so what can you say about that? Monsters go boom. Well, since everything is a grenade, we might as well use them against themselves. So let's have a nice little pile over here of enemies. That will actually boost my weapon damage by 75%. I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, go away. Can we just pretend you're not here? Okay, unfortunately for me, I had to collect that ammo. And that was it, probably. Don't shoot at it. Oh.
You giant cockroaches! I'm right here!
He has a funny voice. Why are there so many of them? Well, looks like you're a big snack. Okay, can we step and save him? This is ridiculous.
August, help me! Grab the gun! August, please! Where are you going?
Okay, move your wheelchair faster. Or someone should push her, I guess. And give her a gun as well. Can you guys stop messing around and eat it already? Oh, August turned himself into a feral. Oh, now he picks up the gun. Why? The gun was too heavy later.
August!
Come on. Can this get any more cheesy or weird? Why is it so dramatic? I mean, with all the energy crackling around and the people who getting wood and I don't know, it's just too much. Yeah, shoot it. Shoot it, it's no longer it's no longer August.
August.
Anyway, he seems intact for being scratched, hit and basically pummeled. Well, I'm sorry, August, you did your best.
What the hell happened to August?
August's people weren't wiped out by savages.
They became savages.
Why would they do that?
Well, sometimes you need to become the monster to kill the monsters, right? Right? Oh, that's weird blood. Don't touch it, it's... Come on, it's an alien. It has alien blood. You don't want to touch alien blood with your... Signs of the
Outrider,
Starship era.
Body. You want to join us?
I'm not there yet. I'm gonna stay a bit longer. Found something you should know about. More of Munroy's writing. Seems he discovered the same thing we did about the Pax transforming.
Does he say why? Why they would do that to themselves?
No, another keystone.
By the way, this is the last keystone.
We'll be waiting for you at camp.
Now, the weird thing is that you will see more of them around the map, so I'll show you what their locations are right now. Some of them are already activated, I mean, it's over here and over here. And I'll actually go after we go and collect the reward to them. So yeah, here, here, and of course over here, the last one. And you need to see the door with three runes on it. And once you activate one of these things, you'll see a rune on it. Yeah, that's a huge floating obelisk. I don't know, the game has a lot of cool concepts like this one. This one I really like. But at the same time... Oh, guys, don't kill me, help me. It's me, your friend. At this point, you would believe that, you know, it's a worse situation and people are kind of getting used to this. And the door is over there somewhere. Okay, now let's see what legendary we get, and after that, I'll just walk on foot to those locations. Yeah, because why not? So after this door, you'll see it over here. Any minute now, we will be there. Any minute. See? Three runes activated, then we can push it open.
The runes on this door. Have I seen this before?
Maybe in your dreams. Come on, you have seen everything. You are an altered. Nothing there, nothing there. It's actually one of the more useful quests because it will give you a good legendary. And I said it will give you a good legendary and it gave me the Grim Marrow, which is one of the worst ones. But I guess now I can destroy it because it has the singularity. Now I could put the level 3 singularity as opposed to the bone shrapnel. But it has a bigger cooldown, sadly. The Bone Sharper has 1 second cooldown. It does more damage, but I think the Singularity needs time to... Well, it just needs time to get ready. Yeah, that was not really worth it. The Grim Arrow I got very, very early. So the legendaries are repeating themselves pretty badly at this point for me. So yeah, that's why you have the quest that guaranteed the legendary one, like the Big Iron. And the Outrider's Bunker. And also some bosses will give legendaries, but again, it's very, very badly designed in my opinion. Okay, now let's go to the other areas and I'll show you the locations and then we'll just see what they have for us next. So that was the third one. The first one is over here. Hey, you can't miss it. Over here, it's activated. The next one is just on your right as you walk up this hill. Now, regarding the legendaries, I think the system is a little worse than it should have been, just because of all the things that you can get. I mean, you get a few legendaries, yes, but after a while they start repeating themselves, even though you haven't played that much. Now, am I going the right way? I hope so. And here is the third one.
For?
Exactly, what's this for? Get an entrance which is over here. Now, let's get out of here. We have wasted enough time. Why does the game look so bad? That would be my only question. I mean, I'm running on DirectX 12 and the extra quality is even ultra. Polish quality view distance is high. Display. I don't know. At some point, you just stop thinking about it. Does the game have a film grain that I'm not seeing? Don't care at this point. The game has so many problems that I don't think they'll be able to fix them in 2 or 3 months, yeah. They also have a weird way of doing crossplay. Meaning that the current crossplay is only between console, Xbox and PlayStation, and Epic Games Store and Steam games. So yeah, that's a thing. I mean, I'm impressed we didn't fight those big cockroaches. Why would they show them to me just... Wait a minute, what happened to the giant cockroaches? Because there were 3 or 4 of them in that room. And August only killed one. Well, consistency for the win, yay. Whoever designed the campaign is probably... It's probably on their first designing of a grand campaign. And the scenes and the voice acting, it's... I mean, the voice acting is not bad per se, it's just they're giving so many, I don't want to say bad lines, they're giving way too many things that are not representing the characters. For example, what do you remember Tiago for? You remember him for, August, I'm your friend, you'll not remember him for fighting, you'll not remember him for actually guiding you to the right path, for that thing where he told you that the antidote is people. Yeah, you'll not remember him for that. You'll only remember the goofy stuff. The insurgent scoundrels call themselves exiles. At this point, I think we have left them behind. So the first chapter is exiles. The second chapter is Pirals.
The signal's coming from just beyond this ridge.
Stay on the lookout. You see any movement, run.
Oh man, put some. Oh. Put some weapons on your truck. I'm bored of getting out to defend you. Why are there bubbles?
Sit tight, people. I'm gonna get some answers.
Babylon sounds like a cool location. Okay, let's play the first part of the map. Well, this is actually a very cool location. This is a huge, huge city. Probably where the packs live before, you know, they turn in themselves into ferals.
What do we have here?
I hope you're not going to eat it.
Zahidi, I found some more writing from Munroy's people. I think we must be approaching their colony. It seems Munroy didn't believe the packs were so peaceful. When their tech started getting fried, he suspected the packs were trying to sabotage them. Then, just as a storm was brewing up, they caught the packs doing one of their obelisk rituals.
Did Munroy think the packs were causing the storm?
I thought the same thing when I first saw August in those ruins in the forest.
Munroy ordered his soldiers to stop them. It was on that day that Dr. Indira recorded the first Pack's deaths.
Please collect all the writing you can find for me. Perhaps we can learn their story.
There's actually a sea over here. Oh, I guess that's water then. If the water is floating, then there was a sea. And hence the boats. Again, this is all human design. Don't tell me this is alien or I'll just delete the game. Yeah, so with the... Look at this guy. Now I shouldn't be rushing like this because yeah, let's get out of there. That was a bad location. Come on, guys, this is stupid. Did I saw an enemy approach me and try to flank me? It's pretty cool design, I like the design. Let's not stay close to this guy. They're so far behind. I mean, if you don't have a sniper rifle in this section, you'll not be able to complete it. And they fire with pinpoint accuracy even though they have assault rifles. I guess their guns don't have a max range. Those guys are no longer a problem. This game is a joke sometimes. How are you supposed to kill them from such a long distance? Ah yes, putting bone shrapnel on this gun was the best decision so far. You are already dead. Now I can be just like the Fist from Fist of the North Star. Can. Now to be honest, if the developers expect us to search all of this terrain over here just for a few pieces of loot, they're mistaken. Okay, I guess I can play a little longer since I like the setting of this area, but again, it's a bit too much maybe.
Explanations from the packs and access to their powers, but they didn't understand. They offered everything they could. They led Monroy through the jungle to their sacred city.
Probably this city, the place we've discovered.
Yeah, it looks like this was a pretty good place to live. I mean, look at all the water and the ships. But again, I don't understand why they made the aliens so dumb. Okay. The more I think about it, the more it annoys me. They are so human. They're basically human at this point. I refuse to call them aliens anymore. They're just humans, yeah. Human that lived in space. Humans that lived in space, I don't know. Okay, so let's see where we are now. That was probably the docks or the harbor. I'm not moving away from the ammunition stockpile. Oh, hi! You're already dead, leave me alone. He is already dead as well, so at this point you just want to refill your ammunition. I think the game did a good job of, you know, putting the refill spots, but sometimes you just... Oh, it's only a destroyer, come on. Berserker, get out of my way. Look at this poor elite. And now let's go a little further. I just want to plant my flag in Babylon. How come? I don't know, it's... I think developers today are using too much of religion and history to kind of make makeshift fantasy realms. I mean, look at this. Yeah, if you can make anything original, I would suggest you do another type of game, not sci-fi. Impaled and exploded. Actually, this worked. Oh no, it's another elite around here. The amount of damage I take is staggering. You know, this is mostly nonsense. And where am I? Somebody give this man a sniper rifle. Someone give me better aim. At least his hobbling makes it harder to hit his head. Okay, no more headshots, body shots all the way. He's actually pretty fast. Except for when he's doing that, where you can basically headshot him all day long. Now, I spy with my little eye more red dots, so that means I probably need more ammo. At this point you're wondering, why couldn't they just give you a little more ammo? Okay, I'll try my best to speed through this, but it's impossible with the bulwarks. And I'm probably dead over here. Yeah, the moment you start to play aggressively, that's the moment you will start dying. So after basically trying to kill most of them, I have to retreat. Oh, shut up. You're no longer a threat. It's it's actually pretty amazing how much your loadout and your skills can change a fight. I mean, those bulwarks were stupidly strong when I first saw them, but now they are pushovers. Can I destroy that cover? No. Well, I almost died over there. I guess that's Monroe or someone. Looks like they conquered the entire city, which is a mistake. Probably the Pax retaliated.
Pax took him to the Grand Temple to try to show him how they communed with the anomaly. But Monroe thought it was a ploy to assassinate him. He ordered the execution down the temple until he could learn how to control it himself.
My God. Monroe, he misunderstood everything.
Which is actually pretty stupid, because again, people are not that stupid. It's not like in the movies where they will destroy entire cultures just because they, you know, wave their fingers wrong. Well, I guess that was a Pax inhabitant. I mean, he says they misunderstood everything, but we don't even know what's going on right now. They don't really tell you much. I mean, they said something, but probably the Pax calmed the storms down or something like that, or can control the storms, but again, it's not really confirmed in the gameplay. You just have to read so many notes and do so many research on your own. It's quite amazing how much they managed to tell a story by just not telling you the story. And by figuring things out for yourself, I mean, they give you all of the details in the writing.
There are countless cages here. They're filled with skeletons. They look like Pax skeletons.
I mean, what else there is to know? Yeah, they got anxious and they killed everyone. But it's the same story told a thousand times. Peaceful people take invaders into their camp and the invaders kill them. Even this guy is no longer a threat. By the time he activates his absorbing skin, he's dead. So why are there the same aliens over where? I mean, I don't think they have a way to cross the desert. Yeah, same assets they used. Where the poronchos, or whatever they're called, the pornot, let's not go there. Why are there aliens in this ancient city of the Pax, which was... I suppose all of the ferals left the place and went to that other place they call their home. But still, it doesn't make sense, because no matter how feral the ferals became, they would still live in their homes. I guess they have no water source over here, or maybe if they jump really high they can get some water. Okay, let's see where we are and then we'll end the video. The central square. Yeah, again, it's a little boring, the story. Yeah, they are so cliché. They even put their flags on, I mean, flags with Monroe's head on top of... I mean, it's pretty much political correctiveness, PC culture at this point. Yeah, let's clear the square. Oh, how I love these guys. Okay, calm down, you'll not be able to kill me. I can assure you of that. Yeah, but giving you two elites at this distance, it's almost like trying to kill you without killing you. Okay, it's not a queen. Thank you for not giving me a queen. By the way, I'm actually watching the radar, so the radar tells me I'm fine to kill this guy. Imagine that. The humans invented slavery on Enoch. Oh man. I want to hit my head with something very hard at this point. Why did they make the story so bad? And it's basically just another repetition of what the colonists did in America, of course, in good old America. The root of all troubles, right? Oh, to move the cart again.
Executed the Pax leaders. Monroy's people started moving into the city. This was their colony. They took over the homes of the Pax, forcing them to work for them, to serve them.
Why is there but oh?
In other words, they made them slaves. They believed the loss of their machinery was the Pax's fault.
Doesn't matter what they believe. There's no excuse for enslaving another race.
Hey, Dr. Zahidi had to tell us that line, of course, because reasons. Oh man, why did I expect something else from this game? It's so... I'm scratching my nose. Yeah. Okay, let's plant our flag in the conquered city. Because that's not symbolic at all, right? And this is the historian area. So that means we're in the central square that's there. Oh, we have about 20 more minutes of gameplay. Yeah, I'll just end the video here and see what is at the end of this. Bye.